All right, y'all. So I am going to work through some of the problems for tonight's homework worksheet 45. Okay. The product of two consecutive positive odd integers. Okay. So your first step right here is that we've got two consecutive positive odds. So if we think back, that's going to be n and n plus 2. Okay. Those are our symbols. So the product means we're going to multiply those. And that's going to equal 143. All right. So we're going to distribute. All right, we're going to move this over. Okay, and then from here, what we are doing is we are factoring. Okay, so I'm still going to use my Xbox with negative 143 and 2. Okay, and you're really just going to have to trial and error here, but here's what I will say about that. You know that the difference between the two numbers has to be 2, so they have to be relatively close together. So, like, I wouldn't start with 3 or 4, because that's going to be a large number where the difference is not 2. So, the answers that we do have are 11 and 13. Okay, we need a positive 2, so we're going to do a negative 11. All right, so what that leaves me with is n minus 11 and n plus 13. So then whenever we use our solving here, we know that our two numbers are positive 11 and negative 13. So that's where the positive comes in. We are going to choose the positive 11, and then 11 plus 2 is going to give me 13 as the second one. So this is the same process you would use on all of these, okay? So number 2 says find two consecutive positive integers. So again, it doesn't say even or odd, so we're just going to use n and n plus 1, such that the square of the first, so the first one was n and they want to square it, decreased by 25 is equal to 3 times the second. Okay, so you have to write out what it says. The square of the first decreased by 25 is equal to 3 times the second. All right, so we're going to distribute here. Okay, and then we're going to move everything over and set it equal to 0. So that's going to be n squared minus 3n, and when you so minus 28 is equal to 0. All right, so now this is what we are factoring. Okay, so we're going to Xbox that. So it's going to be a negative 28 and a negative 3, which gives me my two sides of 7 and 4. So I need a negative 3, so I'm going to go with a negative 7. So n minus 7 and n plus 4. So my two answers are 7 and negative 4. It says positive, so we throw out the negative 4, so it's 7, and the one after 7 is 8. All right, number 3. 3 positive consecutive integers. So if it's 3 and they're positive, just consecutive, it's going to be n, n plus 1, and n plus 2, such that the product of the first and second, so that means n times n plus 1, is, means equals, 2 more than 9 times the third. So 9 times the third would be 9 times n plus 2, and 2 more than that adds 2 at the end. That is the hardest part, y'all, is setting that up. So going from those words into a mathematical sentence, okay? I'm going to simplify this out, and I'm going to leave you to do the rest of the math, okay? So that would give me n squared plus n, 9n plus 18 plus 2. Okay, and then we want to move everything to the left. So I'm going to subtract 9n and subtract 20, which is going to give me n squared minus 8n minus 20 is equal to 0. So that's what you're Xboxing from there. And then once you get your answers, you want to choose the positive one and make sure you find all 3. Okay? All right, let's look at number 4. Same thing. I'm going to set it up. Make sure you're on the right track. 3 consecutive positive integers. So that's n plus 1 and n plus 2, such that the product of the first two is 22 less than 11 times the third. Okay, so that's where you're going to start. I want you to distribute from there and solve. All right, 5, 6, and 7 are all factoring problems as well. How long till it hits the ground? So remember, when we do this, we start by changing this in order. Then you're going to factor your GCF, okay, which in this situation is going to be negative 4. That leaves me with t squared minus 25. The ground is 0, so we set it equal to 0. This right here is a difference of squares, so that's going to give me t plus 5 and t minus 5. Remember, the negative 4 is irrelevant because it doesn't have a t value. So our two answers here would be negative 5 and 5. Since we're talking about time, we throw out the negative, and our answer would be 5. All right, so you're going to do the same process for number 6 and number 7. Okay?